back to Brody. TJ Brody looks for a shooting lane, and that was blocked en route. Looks like Ekholm able to knock that down. Nifty move by Bouchard out at center ice, and McDavid out of the box and to the attack. He'll swing through. Connor McDavid scores! Goal number 55 for McDavid.
And he's already got one assist. Here's the play down low. He's getting pressured. Just a little stop up. He's got his head up the whole way. And that pass creates a little separation. As now all of a sudden McCabe can't close that gap. And man, McDavid just shows great patience here. His head's up the whole way. Once he realizes no one to pass to, watch the look. We've seen a couple of goals lately like this.
And it never got through. The Florida penalty over here is Duclair fresh out of the box. Kalnuk trying to catch him. Duclair got in behind, unable to get rid of an attempt. Both teams are at full strength as Duclair wins a corner battle. Shooting, he scores. That's all, Anthony Duclair. He took a penalty, came out of the box, and seconds later, he puts the visitors in front.
Might have had a breakaway, shows great speed down the wall. I like how wide Kalinuk just keeps them to the outside. But it's the Hawks' second power play unit. No help defensively. Wyatt's left all by himself. And Duclair able to get to the center of the ice and just snap this thing past Kevin Lankinen. And that's a good hard shot right over the pad below the blocker. Hawks playing a dangerous game to start this one, just 8 minutes in.
And Artem Zub on the breakaway. Zub in, scores! A hard tumble to the corner boards, but Artem Zub steps out of the penalty box and scores his first National Hockey League goal.
One, they're still on the power play. They take a little nap, give up a shorthanded goal to Nick Paul, and then moments into this third period. That's a pretty nifty move by Zub. As he takes the lead feed to beat Freddie Anderson, and all of a sudden, it's 5-3.
Here's Zuccarello, down low, Johansson. Johansson already has a goal, back out, saved by Georgiev on Zuccarello, and now Byram just out of the box. Breakaway, moving out on Gustafsson, he scores!
Yep, I came out of there enough times in my career. There's the save by Georgiev, and then the breakaway. Byram, such a great skater. Goals in three straight games now for the Avalanche defender.
Carlson with it, Malkin holding it, ripping it, wouldn't go. It's a 5-on-4, and look out, it's out of the box. It's Mason McTavish on a breakaway, in, scores!
I mean, perfect world, maybe it's up a little higher, but he put that where he wanted it. And just the timing of this penalty, the Ducks player coming out of the box, McTavish breakaway, and does it again.
Able to retrieve. Bouchard across. Evan Bouchard again! Off the post! And Copper out of the box. Bouchard's got to get it back in a hurry. And Copper's got a break. Scores! Leaking through. Mike Smith. And the Avalanche have the lead again.
Time and time again, it looks like the Oilers, with a quick shot by Bouchard through all kinds of traffic, off the bar and out. And all of a sudden you think it's in, nope, going back the other way, and Comfer, who came out of the box, does an excellent job here, pushing Bouchard away, keeping his control, and talk about a focus. He doesn't even know that thing goes in. He's going to the front of the net, looking for a rebound. Mike Smith, unable to close the wickets, squeezes through the five hole and trickles into the back of the net.
Good keep of the line, Keller's got it. Across, a look here, out high for Moser, but it's denied. Schultz is out, and he's in, and he scores.
Ended up losing the puck on the blue line, and Schultz, for a defenseman, one heck of a move. That's a power move. Takes it to the backhand, back to the forehand, and just somehow squeaks it around that left pad of Ivan Prosvetov, who I thought was in pretty good position right there. Not much room, but he certainly found it.
One last rush on the man advantage. Nichushkin carries down the lane, bodies flying everywhere. Markstrom makes a save on the backhand. Great chance that the penalty comes to an end. Another opportunity, Rodriguez shot block. Out of the box, Anderson, he's all alone. Anderson, a breakaway. Anderson scores!
The penalty box, watch his heads up play. Beautiful tape to tape, and now the patience by Rasmus Anderson gets Francouz to open up, and we have a 3-1.
Slafkovský winds that back to Trudeau for Slafkovský. Tees up and shoots, and that deflected wide back out down the ice. Robertson rockets out of the penalty box. In comes Nick Robertson, walking in and shoots, scores. He got that one, and Nick Robertson.
You're out of the box. Trudeau did not start skating until Robertson had the angle, and that's a nice move, taken to the far side and finishing him. But look at Trudeau, he's tired. He doesn't really dig in because he thinks he has time to go get it. The bench has got to let him know he's got to go, as Robertson is jumping out of the box. And a nice finish, and finally,
Freddie Kayers on the ice as they get ready to go back to even strength, which they will now as Pacioretty is out of the bin. And here they go, hitting Pacioretty. He's in one-on-one against Vemelka, and he scores!
Only box and go, maybe I could get a breakaway if I come out of the box. Never happens. But Mark Stone steals this pass, and Pacioretty is walking out. He's in free. There's no one as he touches the puck at the red line. And we talked about his release. This is a rocket over the glove of Vemelka. So Pacioretty.
Here's Barkov trying to clear. Penalty's about to end. Senators hold it in. Chance in front is knocked away. Oh, what penalty killing. Alex Lyons got 41 saves. Chance the other way. Score! It's Nick Cousins out of the box.
It's the puck. And look at the effort by Nick Cousins. And what a move. And he slips it between the legs of Sogard right after he was released from the penalty box, and the Panthers have a half dozen.
An amazing job on the PK, down two men for the full 2 minutes.
That would have been their 10th. Out of the box comes Theodore just as the pass comes to him. Shea Theodore to the backhand, and he scores! Shea Theodore out of the penalty box and into the roof of the net.
Forehand, backhand, and shovels this underneath the bar after Rask doesn't manage the puck in the offensive zone for Seattle. And a nice little move there by Theodore. He doesn't sell it real hard. Let's see if the goaltender bites on the first one there. Yeah, he does. He bites and ends up going down and doesn't cover the top part of the net.
And you think about the
good looking power play here for the Blues. They'd love a late goal to the goal line to Shen. Lost it. And out of the box, Malkin has a break. In alone with seven to go in the period. Shoots, he scores! And Malkin has tied it with 3.7 left.
Get a good look here at net front presence by Braden Shen. Narrowly misses. Jari with a great save. Then the puck just bounces over Tory Krug's stick. And unfortunately, the timing is right to Gino Malkin, who comes in, waits. A very experienced goal scorer. He's waiting for Jordan Binnington to just move, give him a little bit of something. And he goes right above the pad under the arm. Scores that goal. So really unfortunate there for the Blues. Great power play turns into a